holding down part-time jobs at the five and dime. Singing with a band at the Legion Hall on weekend. Doing those standards and dreaming about the big time. You could hear the girls coming home from the canning factory, laughing and talking about their wedding gowns. And the radio was playing Canadian sunset. The night the Chinese restaurant burned down. Heard a sound like a shot about 6 o'clock that evening, as the first of the bottles and the cans began to explode. The new fire truck pulled up with the siren wailing, and half-dressed volunteers hooked up the hose. People said they hadn't seen a crowd like that since the end of World War II. All the regulars from the Rex Hotel came down. They were standing around like they had no homes to go to. The night the Chinese restaurant burned down. And Maggie and me, we were sitting on the steps of the cenotaph together. We looked at each other as if we'd been given a sign. Oh, the crowd was breaking up as the steam was rising from the dying embers in the heart of a dying town. And Maggie and me caught the last greyhound at midnight, the night the Chinese restaurant burned down. It was so long ago, so far away, though it seems like yesterday, like any summer night in any other little town. And the radio was playing Canadian sunset. The night the Chinese restaurant burned down.